I'm Devin Cass. I'm the producer of Synaptic Sugar, and this is our game Relic. In Relic, you play as Sam Ward with her AI companion Gimbal. You're on a quest to get the last of three relics to kind of make her big payday. She's making her way through this derelict ship to get the final relic that she has on her list and make it out with her life. The size of our team was 25 people overall. Some of the challenges of working with such a large team were just keeping everybody on task and making sure that the vision stayed the same and nobody drifted and everybody knew what everybody was working on. That was the biggest challenge. Some of the advantages of such a large team, though, is that we were able to really explore a lot more gameplay than we normally would have been able to, and really flesh out parts of the game that on a smaller team we wouldn't have had the time or the resources to go into.
My name is Jeff Hammond, and I'm the lead designer on Synaptic Sugar, as well as the associate producer. So as a lead designer, I would work a lot with the design team, specifically trying to identify like what are our main goals and making sure that everyone is working towards those goals. One of the things that I've really learned is that a lead designer doesn't mean that I'm the best designer. There's guys on the team that are way better at different things than I am. The role of a lead designer is to coordinate everyone on the design team and make sure everyone has the same goals and the same idea of what needs to be done. And so that's really what I was doing as a lead design, was just making sure that everyone was working together. If someone had problems with something or someone didn't know what to do or how to fix a problem, I was there to help them and find solutions to their problems.
My name is Justin J. Cox, and I'm the audio lead on this team. So my role on this team was to take all of the assets that we all made and make sure that it is integrated into WISE correctly and make sure that anything that is going into the game functions and works and sounds good. There were over 1,000 lines of dialogue recorded. In terms of sound effects, we had a total of 400. And in terms of composition, I think we have a total of 11. Yeah, there's a lot of assets. I would say well over 2,000.
I'm Alex Skinter. I was the animator and co-art lead. So we had these really big open levels, so we had to come up with a design and art pipeline so that we could produce art quickly to fill up these huge empty spaces. And we had our concept artist constantly pumping out these sketches, and we passed it on to the modeler, who would then only model, and then the next artist only unwrapped and textured. And then we had one more artist, Janelle, who put everything into the game and lit it and made the levels look full using whatever we managed to get done.
One of the things about Relic that's a little different than a lot of the other games DigiPen is we had a designated writers team. We had Robert Gervais and Alexandra Lucas working to develop the narrative. Robert we had on staff since the very beginning of the project. When I joined, he had two big binders of just writing. Literally 5,000 years of history for different races. And what that allowed him to do later is whenever we're like, hey, we need a thing that will go here, he's like, okay, cool, well, I've got this battle that happened 500 years ago, and we can just make it from there. And that was really valuable for us as far as developing the narrative and integrating it into the game a lot more. There are two things that I hope players take away from the game. For people who are just downloading it, I really hope that they get that feeling of, you know, grandeur and the fullness of the space and, you know, a complete experience from beginning to end and really getting to explore all of that. And for DigiPen students who take a look at it, I want them to see kind of like, you know, here's what a full game, you know, looks like, and take bits and pieces of here's how we can maybe get some dialogue in our project, or here's, you know, a cool way to fill a space with art. Some of the challenges that we had to overcome because we didn't really have anything to draw from, I hope that we can maybe lend a little bit of inspiration to future teams who want to do something maybe on the same scale. I really would love to see something bigger than what we've delivered come out of DigiPen.